Hi, everybody. Welcome to Stand Up Motivations. I'm Vanessa Klinger, your intuitive life strategist and life coach motivator. Happy New Year. It's New Year's Eve, and I hope you guys are choosing to celebrate everything that you have experienced this year. My wish and blessing and prayer to you is that you take stock onto everything that you've experienced this year and to really just find some way to be grateful. Okay? I wanted to remind you guys about the videos on my website that are out there to kind of help you and guide you and lead you into a way where you can tap into your meditative skills. And if you'd like to learn more about that, you can go to www.stayinlove.com. You can contact me and schedule a session via Skype, telephone, or in person here in the St. Petersburg, Florida area. Okay, today we are going to be talking about the power of your imagination. And the week's topic is actually taken from Dr. Mike Murdoch's Wisdom Commentary, Volume 2. And he writes out how your imagination is an invisible machine inside your mind that creates a picture of something that you would want to have. Last week we covered projection, and essentially projection is the mechanism that allows your imagination to flow. Okay? So that's why we're segueing into imagination and into desire further on into today's topic. Now, I want you to really start going into 2013. I want you to write a list of all the things that you would like to do, be, and have for 2013. And the only way that you can actually get the ball rolling is you have to start using your imagination. And I found that guided meditations really helped me to kind of hone in and focus so that I can focus in what it is I really want. So it really helps me. But I also discovered that you can imagine, but if you don't desire that imagination to take place, then it doesn't work. Now, desire is the root of all of our passions, our power, and our drive toward happiness. Without desire, your imagination can't really work. So look at it this way, like desire as the gas that ignites your imagination. Because when you desire something, you feel it. And feeling is the most important thing when it comes to creating and developing the world that you would like to have. Thereby, you will become a magnet to attract the things that you would like to be, do, and have in your life. The challenge comes that once you get into this flow of imagining by using your desire to create a world that you would like to be a part of, is you have to go with the flow of everything. If you don't go with the flow of it, then you'll be resistant and you'll just block it. So the challenge comes that when everything starts to happen, you must go with the flow of it. So stop focusing on what you don't want and start focusing on what you do want. Because remember, whatever you focus on expands. So the Bible says that if you delight yourself in me, I will give you the desires of your heart. And there's a translation that says, even the secret petitions. And we all know what a petition is. A petition is something you rally and you get people to sign and you take it and you plead it before to get it, you know, taken care of. So the secret petitions are those things in your heart that just between you and God, those little wishes that you would like to have. Now, what you do is you take those secret petitions, and in your time of meditation and prayer, it's when you take them before the Almighty. You activate your imagination. You allow your desire to really, really start, you know, feeling. And you take yourself there. And I challenge you guys, if you do it 30 minutes a day, believe you me, by this time next year, you're going to be in a totally different space and place. If not, in your new world. Honestly. If you start doing it now, you'll start to see immediate results. I'm telling you. It takes a little practice, but once you get into the groove of it, and you really, really start to just allow yourself to just flow into where you're going, then your world will change. I know I have some things that I wanted to see manifest for this year. Am I a little disappointed? I was a little bit, you know. But that doesn't mean it's not here. It just means that everything is a process. So as soon as I found myself getting a little disappointed, I decided to get myself back on track, get back into the flow of things, stay focused, stay positive, stay grateful, stay in that place of joy and happiness, in knowing that all provision is made for me. And I know beyond a shadow of a doubt, because of things that have happened to me this year, that provision is made for me. And I know that the things that I desire and I would like to have, they're here. My job is to stay in the place of joy and gratitude by meditating every day, by taking myself into that world. And eventually, as I continue to align myself with spirit, I will find myself flowing right into the world I want to have. But remember, you got to stay in your place of joy. That's it. I mean, joy is the key. When you're in a place of joy, your desire is amplified, your imagination is ignited, and then you begin to project where you really are. I want to disclose something with you guys. Honestly, I found that where I am now, I find myself like I'm in two different worlds. Does that make any sense to you? I find myself in two different worlds, the worlds that I'm here now and the world that I would like to create for myself. There are times when I feel like I'm not even here, that I'm already in my world. That lets me know that I'm very close to being in the world that I've created for myself. I wish you guys a wonderful new year. See, I hope and pray that you choose to celebrate the year that you have made it through by expressing gratitude. I want you guys to have a wonderful New Year's Eve and be safe. I don't know what we're going to be talking about next week because it hasn't been transmitted to me yet. But I can tell you this. It's going to be a good one. So tune in next week to Stay in Love Motivations. I'm Vanessa Klinger, your intuitive life strategist. Happy New Year, everyone. Peace. When you fall, there are angels there to catch you when you fall. There's a Savior who can hear you when you call. When you call, when you cry, and you cannot figure out the reasons why, know that we